Here's the truth. I don't want to settle down in my life, and neither do you. And that's why you're watching this video. Hello, my friend. My name is Daniel Midson-Short, and in this week's video, I want to talk about something that has always been in the background in my life. I'm sure it's something that you've experienced in your life, and it is this pressure to settle down in life. You might have felt it from family or friends. You might have noticed that all your peers are doing it. You might have noticed that it's just generally something people do in their life. They get to a certain age, whether it's 30 or 40, and they begin to settle down. And it seems like, for whatever reason, it's something that we all should do. But for some of us, we don't really want to do it. We have no desire or need to be settled in our life. We want to keep exploring and growing and developing. And the people around us almost resent us for the fact that we don't want to be like them. So I want to talk about it. Why is there this peer pressure, this societal pressure to settle down, to be like everyone else, to live a more normal life and not to pursue the dreams and goals that we have for ourselves? It's a fascinating thing, and all of us go through it at some stage, and some of us overcome it, and some of us give in to it. It just depends on who we are as a person and where we want to be in our lives. I'm guessing if you're watching this video, you're probably a person who doesn't want to give in to it. You want to find if you can find a way to overcome settling down and live the life that you want to live. The first thing that I want to talk about is the fact that the idea of settling down actually has a double meaning attached to it. If you think about it, those two words, settle down, they kind of mean two different things. On the one hand, they mean, you know, living a more normal, average, conventional life, right? Settling into a relationship, maybe getting married, having children, getting a steady job, buying a home, setting up a retirement plan, all those kind of things. You know exactly what I mean. The settling down is kind of giving up, becoming more calm and letting go of the wild times in your life where you're out partying or traveling or having, you know, ridiculous jobs and careers, and you find something more conventional and serious, okay? On the other hand, settle down actually means to just accept what you can get. And this is the part that frustrates me about this concept of settling down. Very often in life, most people will just give up at a point where they think, well, this is as good as it gets for me, and I'm just going to accept this as my lot in life, whether it's in a career or relationship or, you know, sort of circumstances that they find themselves in. They don't think that they have any more choice or power to actually change their circumstances and to become better or to become more of the person they actually aspire to be. So they're kind of just accepting what they can get by settling down and becoming more conventional. And that's what frustrates me about this concept, that not only is it telling you to be this sort of conventional person, but it's also telling you to kind of accept whatever it is that's in front of you as, you know, that's the best you're going to get in your life. And I don't think that that's true. I think if you keep pushing for things in your life, you keep challenging yourself, you keep improving yourself, there's a hell of a lot more that you can do with your life than if you just accept this circumstance that you're currently in, and especially the people around you telling you that this is as good as it gets for you and you should just settle. All right, so that was definitely a bit of a rant, but you get the point here. The idea of settling down has intrinsically in the concept the idea of just giving up in some respect. And that frustrates me. That's why I've always resisted this concept as a way of life. I don't think it's healthy psychologically, spiritually, emotionally to just feel like, well, this is my life now and this is what I do and this is who I am. There's so much more that you can be. And really this concept of settling down is the complete adverse to that. It's the enemy of self-actualization and improvement, which if you have watched any of my other videos, you know that's a big piece of what I'm about. And that's why I really resist the concept of settling down. The next element of this is this concept I've talked about a lot in different videos, and this is the idea that other people want you to be like them. Why? Because most people, generally speaking, are herd animals. As a society, we tend to conform to the norms of what's around us. We want to do what other people want to do, and we find that doing that helps us to fit in. We're actually rewarded by doing the same things as other people. So other people want us to be like them just as much as we want to be like other people. It's kind of like this cycle that goes around. Now, if one of us breaks that cycle, let's say you don't settle down by the age of 30 or 35 or 40 or whatever it is, suddenly everyone else will start to put more pressure on you to be like them. Why? Because it makes them uncomfortable that you're not fitting into their kind of concept of reality. You're not living your life in the same way that they're living theirs, and that shines a light on the fact that maybe their life isn't as great as they thought it was. I noticed this in a lot of people that I used to hang around. They would get very annoyed because I wasn't married by a certain age, or when I got divorced, or when I moved country. I did all these things that were a little bit cavalier and out of the norm, and people would say to me, man, when are you going to calm down, settle down, stop being like that? You need to get serious in your life. Now, I was very serious. I was a very driven, ambitious person. I was always trying to do my best in life, but I wasn't fitting the norms of what they wanted me to be. And so it was making them uncomfortable as a person, and they felt the need to try to push me to be more like them. I don't think that this was a malicious thing or that they were trying to hurt me or control me, but the reality is that most people are fairly purposeless in their life. They don't have a direction or a dream or a goal that they're trying to achieve beyond just surviving every day. So therefore, if you don't fit that same norm, what that does is it shows to them that maybe the choices they're making in their life aren't the greatest, they're not the most exciting, and especially if you are doing something that's unique or exceptional in your life, it shows to them that maybe they could be doing something more too. But rather than do it, what do they try and get you to do? They try to get you to give up and conform and be more like them. So this idea of other people wanting you to be like them, it's a huge piece of the puzzle or the trap that happens when people are pushing you to settle down. They want you to be like them because it makes them feel more comfortable about their own choices. Of course, the solution to this is that you need to find new people in your life. You need to find different people who will give you different perspectives and maybe people who are more in alignment with the goals and dreams and aspirations and things that you want to do in your life. Now, over the past 10, 15 years, one of the things I've been very particular about is handpicking my friends and people in my life who are people that I would call actualizers, people who are developing themselves and improving and trying to find new ways of growing in their life. People who are like that are very unique, but when I meet someone like that, I make a point of connecting with them and making friends with them and keeping that relationship going. When you do that, you'll find that the more people you are around who are like you, who are more self-actualization minded, goal-oriented, you know, have plans and visions and purpose in their life, you'll find that they don't pressure you to settle down. They want you to grow and develop and be the very best person you can be. So one of the keys to this, to resisting this idea of settling down, is to find people who are more in alignment with the goals and the plans and the dreams and the hopes that you have for your life. If they're pursuing those things as well, get around those people and you'll find that they will help you to develop and grow and keep you on the path to where you want to go. Another important lesson I've learned around this topic of settling down is that there is no right way to live your life. Now, even though it seems like other people might have things figured out or they might be further ahead in life than you, they are following a path that they've chosen for themselves. That doesn't mean that that's your path in life. That doesn't mean that you have to follow those conventions and to fit in with that model of how they're living their life. Overall, yes, there are typical things that most people will do, right? They will go to school, they will get a job, they will meet someone, they'll get in a relationship, get married, have children, buy a home, all those kind of things. They are conventional parts of life, but we don't have to follow any of them if we don't want to. Now, of course, I'm not saying that any of these things are bad by any means. They can be wonderful, enriching experiences if we choose them for the right reasons, if it's something that we really want to do in our lives. But if it's something that we're doing because we think it's the right way to live, then that can be a trap in itself. So I believe that it's important to keep that in mind, that there is no right way to live, because that in itself can be a little bit of a trap, because we feel like, well, maybe we should settle down because, you know, we're not following the right path. There is no right path, my friend. You just have to choose what it is you want to do in your life, and you have to make it up as you go, and however you live your life, that is the right way for you. You know, when I was a little kid, I used to love reading those paperback books that were called Choose Your Own Adventure. I don't know if you remember those books where you'd basically, you get a couple of pages into the book and then it would have two decisions for you. You know, if you want to go down this path, go to this page. If you want to go down this path, go to this page. And it was fun because you got to choose what you did next and each one had consequences. Well, I think life is the same as that. You have to really choose your own adventure at every step. And when you get to the point in your life where you're feeling the pressure of having to settle down or to be like other people or to follow the conventional path, remember that you can choose to turn another page and go a different way if that's what you want to do. Of course, if you want to do the things other people are doing as well, that is totally okay. But if for some reason something inside of you is calling you to do something different, then I suggest that you give it a shot. Even if you fail miserably at whatever it is you try, at least you went for it. And that's what I think adventure is about. Not every adventure has to have a successful ending. In fact, every movie, if everything just went perfectly, we'd find them boring. We love the movies where things go wrong, where there's, you know, excitement or danger. And I think that's what life has to be about a little bit as well. We have to find those adventures for ourselves, and we have to choose them at every part of our life. So my friends, to finish this video, I just want to remind you that settling down isn't something that you have to do at any particular stage of your life. It's up to you to make your own map in life and to choose your own adventures all along the way. And if you do that, I promise you, you'll feel much richer for it because you've lived your life completely instead of just following in the footsteps of other people. My name is Daniel Midson-Short. Thank you for watching. Please leave a like below this video and leave a comment sharing your experiences with the pressure of settling down. Is it something you're dealing with right now or you've overcome in your life? And if you'd like to stay a part of our community, please consider subscribing so you can stay connected. As always, thank you for watching and thank you for improving yourself.